Last week's bomb blasts at Victoria and Paddington heralded the start of a new campaign of terror and disruption by the IRA. It's not only left one man dead and scores of others injured, it's also severely disrupted the capital's rush hour commuter services. As commuter chaos grows, Labour's calling for urgent action to get London moving when stations are forced to close by threats of further bomb outrages.
I do think perhaps we could begin to plan other kind of coach transportation or stopping trains a little further out of London and begin to take those kind of measures so that the inconvenience can be kept to a minimum.
The government has dismissed Labour's plan as impractical and has this message for the IRA.
We're not going to let the terrorists defeat London's transport services 7 days a week. When there is an incident, British Rail's job is to protect the public, and that they've done. They did that this morning. And I think the British public, the overwhelming majority, will understand and put up with the inconvenience. We shall not be defeated.
The Association of London Authorities has today produced figures which show commuter disruption caused by terror alerts and bad weather during the last 2 weeks has cost the capital £125 million.
Well, at the moment, the future is pretty worrying, because if we continue to get the level of alerts that we've got at present, if we get any more bad weather, we see London losing more and more money. And given that we're in competition with European cities like Paris and Berlin, we can't afford to lose that competition by virtue of the fact that our public transport system isn't working properly.
There are fears this latest IRA terror campaign could bring the sort of rush hour chaos experienced almost constantly in Belfast. The government says it's business as usual, but the disruption for commuters looks set to continue. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.